Do you ever jack up the clarity of your photos, but then you're not quite happy with the way it makes your pores look or the way it emphasizes other dust and debris? If so, I've got a quick method to show you in Photoshop that will allow you to keep a lot of the detail of that clarity without some of the unwanted effects. Let's get undone.
Gerald Undone. He's crazy.
Capital day to you, everybody. I'm Gerald Undone, and let's jump right into Photoshop. Okay, so I've got two examples for you today. The first one is of skin. This is my face here, and I have the clarity set quite high. And as you can see, my pores are kind of really standing out in this photo, as well as some other, you know, weird skin stuff going on up here. But I like the way that the clarity made other parts of this image look, so I don't want to get rid of it. And there's a difference between masking out the clarity, you know, when you first add it, and doing this effect, because when you mask it out, you don't really get any of the impact on the color or on the way that the contrast is applied. So this is going to allow you to keep most of that look, but just get rid of some of the things that you don't want. So let's start off by taking our layer over here and going to filter and choose convert for smart filters. This is going to let us make adjustments afterwards if we want. Then we're going to go back into filter and choose noise and dust and scratches. Now I'm going to set these things to their lowest settings so that I can show you how you kind of choose how to set them. So this is our image here, and what you're gonna wanna do first is increase the radius until you find that the stuff that you're trying to get rid of is mostly gone. Don't worry about other aspects, don't worry about the sharpness of the eye or the hair or anything. Only look at the spot that you don't like. So in this case, we're just looking at the pores, and we're just gonna increase it until the pores are mostly gone. Then we're gonna go over to threshold, and we're gonna increase the threshold until we get most of the detail back, but without bringing those pores back as well. So let's just bring up the threshold slowly. And as you can see, now you're getting some of that grain and detail back. And we'll go up a little bit more. Now the pores are starting to come back there around 32. So let's drop it back down a little bit more. And this will be, we'll do a strong version of this so we can really demonstrate it. But let's put it down, I don't know, let's say about 20. So that's pretty strong. So that's with a 6 radius and a 20 threshold. And now all we have to do is go over to the mask here as part of the smart filter. And as you can see, you can turn the dust and scratches on and off, but we can also go into the mask and press Control or Command I, which will invert the mask so that it's not applied anywhere. And then bring up your brush tool and set the flow to something like 25%. And then we're just gonna brush in. Make sure you have a white brush selected. You know, you can press D to make it black and white, and then press X to make sure the white one's up. And then we're just gonna go in and flow over the areas that we want to get rid of at 25%, and with the flow at 25, you know, you can go over it a couple times. So let's start with the pores here, and we're just going to kind of blend those areas in a little bit like that, and then maybe up here in the nose a little bit with that skin, maybe get a little bit of this spot, and then over here. And you just apply it, you know, to taste. Just you look at it and you do it. You can change the brush size and get some smaller details. Don't overdo it, but just, you know, hit the areas that you want. And now, you know, we can zoom out a little bit and have a better idea. And if we turn the dust and scratches on and off now, we can see basically all we did. So that's off. We just hit these areas here with the pores and then back on, and you can see them go away. And if you find that, you know, you did too much, then the advantage of the smart filter is now you can double click on dust and scratches, which brings it back up, and we could increase the threshold a little bit more if we wanted to, you know, bring it back in a little bit and make our changes not so extreme. So let's set it to like 24 this time. Now, if we just turn the entire smart filter off, that's what it was before, and that's what it is now. And so this lets us keep the consistency of the clarity across the entire image, but get rid of some of the pore effects. And I think this is a great, easy solution to do it, and it beats trying to go over and fix all small details. And speaking of fixing small details, let's look at something else like dust and debris. So I have this photo here, and you know, I like some of the aspects of this brushed aluminum, but say I wanted to increase the clarity of this photo, we're gonna see some unwanted stuff happen down here where there's dust and some debris among the brushing. So let's go into filter, and we'll use a camera raw filter just so we can increase the clarity here. Let's just jack it all the way up so we can use this as a test. Press OK. So now we can see what happened. Every little piece of dust really pops now. You can really see this band of debris on the bottom of the transmitter here. And then my pants have all kinds of little specks all over them. And even the fabric of the pan is pretty emphasized now. But maybe you like that part, but maybe you don't like this dirty looking section here. So it's going to be the same idea. Filter. We're going to go back and do convert for smart filters, and then filter, and then noise, dust and scratches. Now this is using our previous settings, so it's already pretty strong, but again, you can go over it the same way. So, you know, we'll just increase the radius a little bit until, so you can see those dust marks go away right away. At 1 they're there, at 2 they're mostly gone, and at 3 they're definitely gone. And then we'll increase the threshold just to bring back to where we'd find it mostly satisfying. Again, we don't want to go too extreme, so probably something in like 24. And the same idea again, let's invert the mask so that it's not applying anywhere. Bring up a brush, have it on white, and set the flow to about 25%. And now if we just go in here, we can brush over these areas as many times as we want to thicken it up and just remove some of that unwanted emphasis. And it works in small areas too. If we just hit these spots on the pants, it's faster than going through and, you know, clone stamping or using like a spot removal tool. And we can just hit these areas as well. And it doesn't completely delete any of the information or replace the information with other sections. It keeps it honest, it's just subdued. And again, you can always adjust the dust and scratch filter afterwards if you want to increase or decrease it. So before it looks kind of dirty and it's got all kinds of junk all over it, and then after, all the junk is gone, it looks a lot cleaner. And then when you zoom out a little bit, say maybe you wanted to frame it up like this, off, on, you're not distracted by this weird band of junk down here. So that's pretty much it. It's really simple, it's really easy to do. The whole point of this is that that way you don't have to mask out your clarity completely, because I do find that it creates sort of an uneven look with the contrast and the colors, because clarity heavily affects, you know, the way that your image is saturated and how light seems to be bouncing off of it. So this way you get to keep a consistent look, but remove some of the stuff that you don't want. But that's gonna be it for me. I hope you found this video helpful or at least entertaining. And if you did, make sure you leave it the old thumbs up and consider subscribing if you haven't already. But if you did not find this video helpful or entertaining, feel free to hit the dislike button twice. All right. I'm done.